everybody, and welcome back to more Talos Principle. I forgot to mention at the end of the last video, but you'll notice that we've got the A set of sigils in the upper left with all the green ones done, but I'm going to actually wait to input those in the gate over there until we've completed all the other ones that we can access right now. So I'm going to go to number 3 for this video, and... ooh. Well, this is interesting. We've got a green one and a couple yellow ones, but now we've got a red sigil as well. So that's going to be interesting. And there's 2 stars here, not just 1. Alright, well, let's read the terminal here. AIfeedback.email. We keep discussing what an artificial intelligence would mean to us and how it would change our understanding of the world. That's a great topic, and I think we've covered it extensively. What we've barely mentioned, though, is the other side of the coin. I mean, our lives would still be what they were before, AI or no AI. The question I think we should discuss, even if it's all completely hypothetical, is the perspective of the artificial intelligence itself. What would it be like to be that creature? To suddenly come into being, created by others as an experiment? To have all the information about yourself, to know exactly how you function? What would you think about the world? Would you see meaning? Beauty? How would you judge humanity? Where would you see yourself fitting into the grand scheme of things? I think we should try to put ourselves into the shoes of such a being. Dear Alexandra, thank you for your feedback, but this is a philosophy course, not science fiction. And that's why I almost gave up on my studies. Teamleads.email. We're blessed to have so many people contributing to this project, but we've got to make sure everyone is on the same page. Please refer to the following people when... Alexandra Drennan, Project Lead, AI Module. Nadia Sarabhai, Institute Coordinator. Rob McLean, EL Software. Trevor Donovan, EL Hardware. George Jameson, Generation Module. Alan Jameson, Scenario Module. Bob Rakowski, Simulation Module. Radia Brickmont. Aurora Calvin, Link Hardware. Omar Garib, Link Software. Somebody Lanning, Maintenance Module. J.E. Harrison, Diagnostic. Frank Gaktai, Memory Module. We've seen a reference to him before. Jared V. Shmilov, File Sys. And Sun Wei Yang, Talos Unit, formerly Soma. Though not directly part of our project, the archive team is sharing both physical and digital space with us. If there are any technical issues to resolve, please contact their project lead, Arkady Chernyshevsky. Don't worry, he's nice. And Straton of Stagira.wiki. Straton of Stagira, 311 to 254 BC, was a Greek materialist philosopher associated with the Peripatetic school. An admirer of Aristotle, he was a proponent of empiricism with a fierce critic of philosophy that placed belief before observable truths. Though unpopular with many of his peers for his often acerbic personal manner, his commentaries on Aristotle were considered an important work. Much of his writing was lost in the destruction of the Library of Alexandria. Okay, so not a whole lot new there, but we did get a rundown of all of the names of people who are involved with this whole project. So, according to this sign, we're going to be going to the green one here. So let's go do this one first. Stashed for later. Okay. What we got over here? Okay, this is a dead end, but we can see the sigil here, and hopefully this will come down to give us a quick exit. Let's see what we've got. I heard a turret making its humming noise. Alright, so this is kind of like the poking a sleeping lion puzzle, where we can't really get that right away because we'll die. Ooh. Looks like we're going to need a key to open this. I guess if we didn't get the star earlier, this would be our introduction to keys. We even have a message saying that the door is locked. Okay, I'm just going to wait for that to pass by real quick. Let's run over here. Alright, so there's nothing over here, but we do get a view of this whole area, which shows that there are actually 2 turrets to take care of, not just 1. Thankfully, we can walk right in front of them without too much problems. Uh-oh. Okay, that was close. A little too close for comfort, but we did get the keys. Oh, I could have just come this way. Wow. Way to go, JB. Okay, let's go in here and grab that jammer. And by using this to hold the mine, we should be able to grab the other one without any problem. And I'm going to use these to jam... Oh, we can't actually get line of sight to that here, can we? There we go. And let's get this one. So we'll free up the mine, but it's not like he's going to grab us here. Alright, so now we just need to go back this way and jam that. Perfect. So that wasn't so bad. And the gate drops. Excellent. So now we've started a group of green sigils that correspond to B. Whatever that means. Okay, let's go over this way first. I'm going to do the two yellow ones, and I'll go to the red one. So far, no sign of the star, or either of the stars yet. A bit tied up. We got several things going on here. We've got... Oh. Okay, so this kind of takes the sleeping lion concept and turns it up a notch here. We've got two jammers that are occupied with objects that are currently disabled. And then we've got another one over here. So I think what I'm going to do first is I'm going to free up the jammer that's holding this, since we've got that one there. And that should enable us to grab this, like that. Okay, so now, if I'm not mistaken, this should get the mine destroyed. There we go. And hopefully, we can now take these over here. There's probably one more we need to do. Yeah, there we go. Ah, there's a star right there. Okay. Well, this shouldn't be too bad. I think we can just use the open gate and go right around. There we go. I suppose if you had been going through the game without knowing anything about the stars, this would be your first introduction to them, since this one's pretty easy to notice. Which is nice, since it's nice to know about these things pretty early on. Let's go to the other side, since that's the red one over there. What is this over here? Got some broken statues or something. More of the same. Seems like these statues don't have any heads, which is... kind of odd. Locked me up, swallowed the key. Okay. Looks like we're going to have more keys again. I gotta mention, I think that last puzzle wasn't really as bad compared to the first one, so I'd say that one should have had the green sigil and the first one should have had the yellow one. Okay, there doesn't seem to be anything here. Ah, here we go. Walked right by it. I hear a turret. Wonder where that could be coming from. Ah, there we go. So we got a turret there and a turret over there. There's the key, or set of keys. So all we need to do is open this, which will now render the gate here obsolete as far as needing to use it. And this enables us to get another jammer. So that, in turn, should allow us to go and... Wait, that was where we got the keys. This area. This is where I meant to go. Just in case, I'm going to juggle these here. Yes, here we go. You did need to do that. And we get a nice ladder back, which is nice. I'm kind of disappointed the game doesn't let you, like, walk around on top of the walls once you climb a ladder, but it's alright. Okay, so those are the green and the... Wait a minute, did you see that? Looks like something just glitched right there. It's kind of a little odd. So that's the green and the yellow puzzle. So now let's see what this red one is all about. More headless statues. An escalating problem. Okay. We got a mine here. And a wall. Nothing in here in particular, but I'm curious to know what happens when we turn this off. It goes up. Fascinating. So mines can not only stay on the same level, they can actually go up stairs. Whenever they're programmed to do so, I suppose. Here we've got another window. And we can go back down through here. Well, I suppose we can use this opportunity to jam this from this angle. From that spot, or actually let's move back a little bit. So that way maybe we can pick it up from up there. Because if we want to take the jammer with us, this is probably the best way to do it. There we go. Cool. Alright. Nothing in particular that's noteworthy there. Ooh, we're going to need a key to open that. And, oh, we've got a bit of a problem here. We need to use the jammer to open the gate, but there's also a turret there. Ah, okay. So there's a... Whoa. Easy. Let's try to avoid death. I think we found where the keys are, though. Alright, I'm just going to follow this guy around here. Okay, so we can get the keys. And let's get out of here before we die. Alright, so we can open the gate here. We still have an issue here, right? Because we've only got one jammer. We haven't seen any other jammers anywhere. And we can only disable this gate. I mean, we have to do that in order to even get in there. But once we get in there, it's instant death. Well, I gotta admit, this actually stumped me for a while. Because I kept looking for another jammer. I thought for sure there was a jammer hidden somewhere in a corner over here. But there isn't. So based on what we know, what is the only other option left? Well, if you think about it, there really is only one other option left. And it involves something that we haven't really noticed before, which is that the mines can turn. Not only can they go up and down things, they can also turn. And this is something that I didn't really notice originally, just because they never really had this behavior exhibited in any other puzzle before. So I never really thought that mines would be able to do that. But considering that we were introduced to the concept of elevation here, and there's really no other options, it makes sense that, it makes sense that the mines would be able to go up here, if only to go in there and destroy the turret for us. It's just rather counterintuitive based on what we know so far. Pretty cool ability, though. So, I'm going to go down there, and, oh, we need to figure out how to do this. Whoops. I didn't mean to jam you, I meant to jam that. So now it's going to go way back down. See, it just takes a little bit of experimentation, but I actually was going around that whole area there a bunch, trying to figure it out. Because I thought there might be some secret that I didn't realize was hidden there. There we go. It is possible, by the way, if you go over here in... wait a minute. Where is that area? There's an area over here where you can climb... I thought you could climb a ladder to... Yeah, there's a ladder here. I guess this is the gate that drops down after you're done? I thought... Okay. Never mind. I thought I saw a Let's Play of somebody doing this where he jumped up, grabbed the star, or the sigil, and then died. You also see here that there's an area where you can seek counsel. Divine spirits, I am in great need, and I seek your counsel. Do not doubt yourself, you have already overcome this trial. Autoresponder version 0.0.001. So yeah, these council things are here if you need help on the red puzzles. And actually, if you didn't do this after this, if you did it when you were actually trying to solve the puzzle, it would actually say that you needed to find a messenger. Ah, here we go. Yeah, so you actually need to find where these messengers are located first before using these. Otherwise, it's just gonna the autoresponder will just deny you the help. And I'm not going to really worry about doing that for now because thankfully we won't actually need to use the messages here. But there are here if you do need help. I spent much time waiting for the designer to take my hand until I realized that he had been guiding me all along. I realized that it isn't for me to seek his help. It is for me to help myself. 1W Faith, version 10.1.0177. Alright, so that's all the puzzles, but we still have one star to get. And I gotta say, this is probably one of the few stars in the game that I personally just don't like. It's one of the most gimmicky things in the whole game. And it involves, see if I can find it, there's another one of those QR codes located somewhere here. I think it's this area. Is it this area? I think it's one of these things that looks like a bench. Where is this? Is it over here? No? Okay, I know there's a QR code here somewhere that gives you a hint toward this. But the trick with this QR code is that it actually does not give you anything here in the game. You actually have to have a QR code scanner to use it. And I gotta admit, this idea I just don't approve of. Is this it? It's not, but it's clear I'm not the first to walk this path. In fact, the whole thing seems to have been consciously designed, but by the voice in the sky or some other force. Sheep, version 69.1.0108. Okay, I know this is here somewhere. Let me see if I can find it. Is it on one of these little statue pedestal things? It is kind of nice to look around just to see if you can find some of the messages left by the other course participants, if you want to call them that. Nope, not there. Well, anyway... You'll see that there's all these pillars here that have Roman numerals plastered on them. There's also this these four quadrants here with the water all around the area. And I am still at a loss for where this is. I know it's somewhere in this immediate area. Is it this? No, not that. Now we're just back here again. Alright, we'll find this. I want to find it so you can at least get a good look at it in case you want to scan this yourself. I'm planning not to really do it here, I'm just going to tell you what the solution is. But the solution, let's just say the solution to this is kind of a little bit silly considering that there's all these pillars all over the place. And you'll see what I mean by that here once I find this. Is it somewhere closer to the middle? Oh, here it is. It's right here behind the terminal. Alright, so yes, you can look at this QR code right here. And I'll get to that terminal here in a minute. But you'll see that it doesn't actually produce anything for you if you just mouse over it like the other ones do. However, if you were to scan it with a real QR code reader, it would say, "The Eagle has landed," among other things, and then it says a bunch of hex code afterwards. And if you enter the hex code into a hex translator, you're going to find this date, 1969/07/20/2018. And what this is supposed to be is it's a reference to the moon landing, where the Eagle was the name of the lunar, the landing module, basically. And what you're supposed to figure out is that 7 and 20 are the Roman numerals that you need to press in order to find the star. Personally, I don't like this, because there are so many other numbers in that thing. You could just easily go through all of that, and you could easily make it such that 7, 2, and 0 are pressed. Although, I don't know if there's a 0, so, I mean, I guess you could eliminate that possibility. But still, the fact that there's all those numbers, and that you have to press these particular ones, on top of having to use two tools outside the game, is a little bit unfair, I think. It's an interesting idea, not gonna lie, but it's a little bit mean. So as long as we press these two, we should be fine. There we go. And let's see if I can find the one that's gonna... I think it's this one, if I'm not mistaken. Is it this one? I think the water drains first. There we go. There's the star. That is probably the toughest star in the game as far as having to figure out a solution. Let's go ahead and see what the terminal wants here. Attention, your user profile has now been generated. Download profile? Yes. Downloading user.prof. Registering profile. Congratulations, your new user account has been registered. Would you like to see the details? Sure, display conflicts. User provided an objective response when asked for a subjective one. User denied moral authority but defended moral claims. It's interesting, because one of the recurring themes of this game is that you're going to be challenged on your answers to some of these questions. And my basic kind of the basic principles I was working with were that I was basically providing, you know, value to the moral claims, but maybe it's the libertarian side of me. I don't really have much sympathy for what the computer here was defining as moral authority, which was basically forcing you to act on moral claims outside of conscience. So I can see why a computer would find this to be contradictory, but that was my reasoning behind it. Display psychological profile. Psychological profile. You may already be criticizing your own performance, but it's clear you understand how the world of ideas affects you, even if you are sometimes weary with the realities and allow your preferences to dictate your beliefs. You have a great deal of unused capacity, which you have not turned to your advantage. Disciplined and self-controlled outside, you tend to be worrisome and insecure inside, but you pride yourself as an independent thinker and do not accept others' statements without satisfactory proof. Well, that last phrase is certainly true. Display account privileges. Profile privileges. Basic account privileges only. Due to outstanding notes on your account, and despite displaying many of the characteristics of being a person, you cannot be granted admin status at this time. In the meantime, please enjoy the basic account functionalities. Access comm portal. You already hold a basic account. Network access is restricted to administrators. Please enjoy the basic functionalities. Okay. Support tickets. I'm sorry I wasn't better able to assist you. If you're still encountering a problem, please describe it. Arg. Is that a Monty Python reference, I wonder? I like how you can support a ticket. Send a ticket saying that. Oh, that's awesome. Okay. All right, so let's go ahead and exit here. I think we can call it at this point. And next time, we're going to go to door number 4 and see what's behind that one. So until then, everybody, thank you all so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video today. If you liked it, be sure to hit that like button, and I will catch you on the flip side. So take care, and I will see you next time.